Well, let's get started. Thanks for taking the time to check out our webinar on using scripts in remote.it. My name is Gary Warsham. I'm head of support at remote.it, and I'm going to tell you all about writing a script. So agenda today is prerequisites, what you should know to get the most out of this, overview of scripts, how scripts work, when to use scripts, uploading and executing scripts, tips and tricks, and Q&A. And please use the chat window for any questions that you might have. And then I'll get to them, and then that will allow me to keep track of them and answer them all in order. Thank you very much. Okay, so prerequisites for this webinar are that you know what remote.it is, and that you've used remote.it to make connections, and that you have basic Linux scripting experience using Bash or the Bourne shell. What is a remote.it script? It is a text file containing a series of commands to perform on the target device and report back status. So it is, in fact, just a regular shell script. And it can be written in any language supported on the platform, such as Bash, Bourne shell, Python, or PHP. However, it is currently supported only on the Linux platform. When should you use a script? Well, when you have a repetitive action that you would like to perform on some of your devices, including all of them, such as running any command, which could include controlling GPIOs, rebooting devices, getting status back from devices, or transferring files to a bunch of devices, as in the case of content distribution or firmware updates. Here's an overview of using a script. You write a script and upload it to your remote account. Then you will select one or more devices in the View Devices page, and then from the Actions menu, select Execute Script. The job server then sends the script to the devices using the bulk service installed and running on the device. The devices then perform the actions defined in the script and communicate back to the job server using the ConnectD Task Notify script, which is installed as part of the ConnectD package that you installed in order to set up your services initially. And then at the end of the script has to send back a special message indicating failure or success. And that also uses the ConnectD Task Notify script. The status function in the sample bash scripts wraps the ConnectD Task Notify call for ease of use. So we'll have some examples later showing how to use a task right here. Okay. To use the status functions, you need to supply two arguments. The first one is for a status message in the column A, B, C, or D specifies the column to place the message. And I understand at this point, I will show you the status columns in just a bit. And then for the task completion status, the first argument is 1 for the task completed successfully or 2 for it failed in some way. The second argument is the message to display. In the case of a status update or in the job status window. So the command line status A, quote, wrong firmware version, end quote, writes this message into status column A. And we'll show you this all in just a bit. So here are the overview of executing a script. And right now I'm just going to change over to my remote account and show you what is written on that page, show you the actions written on the page. So here's my remote account, and I need to go to settings, click on preferences, and then there's this checkbox that says show advanced managed devices menu. Okay, that's where bulk scripting is located. And when I do that, the Manage Devices menu shows up. And I'm going to go over here and I'm going to upload a script. Now, the scripts from this presentation are available on our docs.remote website. And I've got a bunch of them here already just to do this quickly. So I pick the script. I need to select executable script or program in this dialog, and then I click on upload. In just a few seconds, I expect to see the upload succeeded sign here, and then I can either upload another script or cancel out of this dialog here. Now I'm going to return to the View Devices page, and you can see I now have these status columns. So the status columns are where the messages are going to come back. So I've uploaded the script, which was getpy status. And what I'm going to do here is show you the kind of commands that I would normally run at a command line in order to find out something about this device. So for example, I can run the df command. This is disk free, shows me a number of my partitions and what the data is. If I want to see all the processes that are running, I run a psax. This will show you a whole bunch of stuff. I have things like uptime that will show me how long it's been since this system rebooted. And another command to show me the version of the connectd package, sudo dpackage minus s connectd. I can look at that. And the reason I'm doing this is because I'm going to do these very same commands in a script. Okay, so that's me doing that at the command prompt. But if I do that over and over, I'm going to want to automate that with a script. So let me go back to my account. And I've selected both of these devices. Now, these are two different devices. One of them happens to be Raspberry Pi. The other one is a Ubuntu VM over at Amazon. And from the actions menu, I'm going to select execute script. And then I'll choose the basic status, getpy status basic.sh script. I'm going to check this box to allow these status columns to get updated as the script executes, which is what I usually want when I'm running a small number of scripts. Finally, I click on submit, and this will take a few moments. And now you can see that these status columns, these cells, are getting filled in with the information from those commands just the same way as if I had run that at the console. And so the next thing I'm going to show is just a way to optimize this display, because this is a lot of information that I don't want to actually look at. So I'm going to run a different script. Again, I'll select both devices. I'm going to interject here. One thing you can also do to clear the status information without running a script is to go again to the actions menu and select clear status. That will give you a dialog saying which columns do you want to clear. And then that clears that all up. That's ready to run something else. So now I'm going to run, I forgot to select 1 to 1,000 devices. So let me do that first. I'll select 2 because I have 2. I'm going to select execute script again, and then I'm going to run this other script that I wrote, which is also available at the website, which is has expressions that filter out a lot of the extraneous information. So you'll see that by fine-tuning my commands and expressions that show what is in here, I can trim down the information that I display and optimize this just by learning a few simple commands. Let me just go back here and show you the job status page is under manage devices here. And this will show all the scripts that I've run. So these are the last two scripts that I ran. And you'll see this one here says that it's running. If I click on that, they'll show me that both tasks in here are actually done. So one of the things that you need to know is that there's a little bit of a time delay between the scripts running and the status updating here. And that's normal. And that time delay can be about 3 minutes. Okay. I'm going to go back here. Okay, here's some tips and tricks for the writing scripts. Please start with the supplied examples. You have to terminate your script with a status 1 okay, success, or status 2 failed command. Otherwise, they'll stay running. You can clear a status cell in your scripts by executing, for example, for the status A column, status A, that thing is two single quotes next to each other, so null string, and that will clear a cell. If you're writing scripts in Bash or C#, you should learn how to use the Linux utilities like grep, awk, and sed to trim down the information you want to display. The sample scripts do show those being used. If you want to use something other than one of those interpreters, such as Python, you can just change the first line to point at whatever interpreter you have, including Python, PHP. It's helpful to test script fragments at the console first before incorporating them into a bulk script. So write them up and test them on the console, and that'll save a lot of time. It's important to know that scripts execute as the root user, so you don't need to use sudo, and if you're not careful, you can do some bad things to your operating system. When you're debugging scripts, note that they download to the temp folder. And in order to look at the scripts that get there and make sure they're okay, we recommend you install and connect to a remote SSH service. In your script, you should write frequently to a log file, which you can review at the console. The examples also show that. And you can also send intermediate results to a status cell. So you can have several status A commands in a row as you're going through step one, step two, step three in your script, and this will show you where you are, and it's very handy. As far as job status, one task, which would means a script running on a device which does not complete, will keep the whole job in the running state. So you need to click on that job status if it stays running for a long time and see if maybe one of your devices has failed. If you suspect something is stuck, just cancel the job and then debug what happened. Note that canceling a job does not undo the action of the script. So if you canceled it, if you had 10 devices selected and you canceled it after three of them ran the script, those three ran the script and the other ones didn't. And like I already said, the job status can take several minutes to update, so be patient. Note that only the bulk service is required to run scripts. Scripts may operate differently on different versions of the operating system or different devices. As I already said, scripts are only supported currently on Linux, and scripts cannot pause for user input, which makes them a little different than scripts you would write to execute at the console. Although some scripts will request a parameter such as the name of a file to be sent, but that's just at the beginning. For further information and to contact me if you want to about writing scripts or anything to do with the remote it product, send me a support ticket through our support website or through an email. Thank you very much for attending, and hope that was educational and useful to you.